We're going to talk about the wiring connections of the Mitsubishi mini-split air conditioners. The reason is that different models often come with different connectors, which can cause confusion. This leads to mistakes when making the connections. But today, I will explain everything to you in complete detail. Once I explain it to you, you won't forget it for the rest of your life. Look, right now we have a Mitsubishi model here, and I'll explain its wiring to you. There's no connection at the top. It's blank here. Now, when I show you its connections, you'll see they come from the side. Look here. Underneath is where the connections are made. This is the main cable for the power supply. Besides that, here's the outdoor unit placed here, and its wiring is done like this. I'll show you the wiring, and now we'll do the wiring and check it out. So friends, look at the unit's wiring connections. They look like this. This is the indoor unit, and the supply first goes to the indoor unit and then to the outdoor unit. This is the main supply. Now let me show you. At point one, there's always the line. Point two is for 2N, which is the neutral, and point three is the signal wire or communication wire. So now we'll make the connections here and show you how to do it properly. Look, friends, we have now completed the wiring connections. For point one, we have connected the black wire. 2N is for the neutral. The red wire is attached to number three, and the green-yellow wire is for earthing. I'll explain later in the video why we've connected them this way and also share a technique to help you memorize it easily. Now look, we've moved to the outdoor unit. For the outdoor wiring, you can see points 1, 2N, 3, and earthing. We've connected the black wire to point 1 just like we did for the indoor unit. The white wire is connected to 2N, and the red wire is attached to point 3. You can also swap the wire colors and still connect them as long as the same color wires are used for both the indoor and outdoor units. This will ensure the connections are correct, because the supply is coming from the indoor unit to the outdoor unit. Try to always start from the indoor unit and then move to the outdoor unit, and your connections will always be correct. Now we've talked about the unit where the power supply side is connected. Let's discuss another unit we have here. This is where many of my friends get confused. Look, this is also a Mitsubishi electric unit. The confusion often arises because of the labels S1, S2, and S3. People don't understand what S1, S2, and S3 are. In this outdoor model, the connections look like this. Here, you can see the L and N, which are for the main power supply, as the supply is coming from the outdoor unit to the indoor unit. You can also see S1, S2, and S3 written here. Now, look friends, we've made the connections. We've used the same technique here. The black wire is connected to S1, the white wire to S2, and the red wire to S3. The earthing is connected to its designated spot. Similarly, if we move to the outdoor unit, the same technique is used, and this is the rule. We've connected the line and neutral wires, as well as the wires available at the time. You should remember which wire is connected to which point, so when you make the main supply connection, you'll know exactly what to do. This way, you can successfully make the wiring connections. Now, let me explain the technique behind S1, S2, and S3, and give you a complete explanation. Also, friends, a 2-ton unit is placed here. Its wiring is also quite similar, with no major differences. It still has the same S1, S2, S3, and L and N labeled, and this is a 2-ton unit. Let me explain the technique. Friends, here is the indoor unit connector, as you can see. Similarly, I'll show you the outdoor connector. Look at it carefully. Now, check the connector of another model as well. Once again, this is the outdoor connector. If you pause the video and look closely, you'll find what's common between them and also see what's different. If you've already understood, that's great. But if not, let's move forward in the video and I'll explain further. So how does it work? The indoor unit has 1, 2, and 3 labeled on it, and the outdoor unit also has 1, 2, and 3 labeled. Now look, in all models, 1, 2, and 3 are common. They are labeled the same in all of them. But if you look at the first model, you'll see 2N written on it, which is different, while in the other model, there's an S labeled with everything. The company has used S purely for identification. You can interpret it as meaning switch or signal wires, but otherwise, it doesn't mean anything more. Another difference you might not have noticed, which I'll point out, is the color of the wires for S1, S2, and S3. Look closely. S1 is black, S2 is white, and S3 is red. This means the company has specified the color of the wires as well. To help you understand this, let's head over to Japan, since Mitsubishi is a Japanese company and they apply their wiring standards here. Now we've arrived in Japan, or rather, we've come to the wiring standards of the entire world. They've shown the three-phase wiring color codes as well as the single-phase ones. Let's talk about Japan specifically. When we zoom in on single-phase wiring, you'll see that line and neutral are separate and assigned to black and white wires. This is why the company uses black and white as well. The S can stand for signal or switch. You can interpret it either way, but they've just used S to make it distinct from other connectors. There's nothing to be confused about here. Everything else is the same. If you've understood this explanation, I believe you won't forget it, and you'll be able to make these connections easily. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.